This isn't looking good.
Okay, whole other world. How many of these are there? Find these segments, huh? Well, let me turn that talking ball of light, hang out, and meditate. Come on, come on!
That's far enough. Axeldeck. It stands before the Eternal Empress, Mistress of the Red Court, favored of the Thane. Yet it is nothing. Hoofless, feckless, interloper.
Hey, easy now.
And where it stands, it dies.
Whoa, maybe we can talk about this?
Dafka. It seems it shall live for now. But tell us, Paxeldeck, what woes does it bring this time? It stands before the Eternal Empress, once and future ruler of Yesha. Her Majesty asks once more, what brings the Paxeldeck to her court? Answer, for eternal life is not the same as eternal patience. Her Majesty is unsurprised by its solipsism. From the Krell to Ford to the Destroyer, Paxeldeck ever served the wants of the Self. There is no name more cursed in these royal halls. When the pestilence came, Ford succored the schismatics. Treachery turned to ruin. Ruin to desperation. Her Majesty would see Ford bleed, would see all Paxeldeck put to the blade. But the Paxeldeck prowess is fearful. Ford, the Destroyer, and others were staggering, undeniable. Perhaps Paxeldeck's strength can serve to liberate rather than oppress Her Majesty. In her eternal wisdom, will grant it grace. The Paxeldeck's life in exchange for another's. Her permanence has spent many lifetimes communing with the Thane. The Holy Tree grants euthanasia, but also clarity. The Paxeldeck needs salvation, power to overcome the only true enemy. Do not demur, for it has not the guile to see beyond her eternity. All dance to the same world song. Different notes, different parts, same tune. The Paxeldeck seeks the abomination. It would slay this creature, and her eternity would see it slain. In this way, it will prove its loyalty and worth. For Her Majesty will not suffer another transgressor. It deserves death, yet spits at the alternative. Her infinitude is too gracious. Yet let it decide. Her permanence savors either outcome. She desires only to bring the Nunyutav back to the pen, to draw her people back from the abyss created by the sundering. But the abomination bedevils her will. A horror, wretched in her sight. Let the Paxeldeck face this dark spirit. Be not her bane, but her blade. Then the Paxeldeck shall have its reward. The path to desire is neither easy nor safe. Go forth, Blade. Cut away the rot that plagues this world. Prove there is one Paxeldeck that is more useful living than dead.
Okay, this is it.
I've got enough of that.
Summons me from my ethereal wanderings.
Nuzar! What kind of beast is this? Paxel Tech. I can share my wanderings with you. But first, I seek the knowing, the truth of nature held within your ark. You want to answer? So I will ask. Answer these questions true, sweet beast,
so that your arc may be known and your eye may open. And do choose wisely. Answer from your heart. The Krell King comes to you for a boon. A twisted fruit that will slay his enemies. By giving him this, you will end a war that has lasted many years, but you will sentence another to certain death. Do you give the king the means to kill his enemies, or do you send them away and risk war? Well done. Your closest friend is about to be wed. It is the day of the ceremony, and all are happy. But for you, have learned that if you don't, it may lead to later grief. Do you stay silent and enjoy the party, or tell the truth and ruin the day? Now let me think. Oh yes! A runaway cart races down the track toward five miners. You and a stranger are on a footbridge above, witnessing this. The stranger, who happens to be very large, leans over the rail to get a better look. You could save the lives of the five miners by shoving him onto the track below, stopping the cart with his bulk. Do you push the stranger, or risk the death of the five miners? Oh, what fun this is! You lead a mountain expedition that is stranded in the lofty reaches. Your retinue includes a family of six with an inherited nutrient deficiency. One individual's kidneys contain large amounts of this nutrient. The family can be saved if you remove this individual's kidneys to extract the nutrients. The would-be donor is opposed to this plan. They will not die, but their health will be forever compromised. Do you save the family, or do you let the family suffer by sparing the unwilling donor? It's not every day a question determines the course of your destiny. Or is it? Two clans have warred for generations. Your matriarch calls for a battle of champions to bring a final end to the bloodshed, and you are chosen to fight. Your opponent is the eldest but weakest son of your enemy. He offers you no threat, and you best him easily. But you must slay him to end the war. Do you spare the scion of your family foe, or kill him and end the war? Ha! Oh dear. No bother, it's nothing. Moving on. You have chosen your path, sweet beast. Your heart is true. May the power of the Doe's Eye free you from your incarnate shackles. In the arc of every being, there are two eyes. We may see out of either, but most favor one over the other. The Ravager's Eye is dynamic, driven, and endlessly hungry. Yet for all its power, its vision is clouded. The Eye of the Ravager rarely sees beyond its own satiation. Like an animal chasing its tail, it knows no rest. The Doe's Eye sees only what is before it. The gift of the Doe is subtle, easily missed. It is a most mysterious presence inside oneself, conferring power without force. Just as the Doe itself cannot be sought, nor tracked, nor hunted. By answering true, sweet beast, you give me a wink, and now the gifts of your dominant eye will be open to you. Would you care to hear a tale? It is about those who see as you do. I will tell you of Ramaril, the servant child of the Vaunt. I found Ramaril as a babe, large and angry as only a hungry babe can be. Nothing became of him, as it happened. He grew from a great crying babe to a great quiet Pan. He served without word or complaint. None knew his name, for though one might thank the creator of a meal or a washroom, who even considers the child who merely cleans up after? When the Krell came, they laid siege to the temple. None could escape nor call for help. All were doomed. The Doe's eye opened in Ramaril that day. He was no fighter and had no training of any kind. But he lifted the largest shield he could find and told the others to run once he'd made away. He drove dozens of Krell over a cliff, and himself with them. Later, his masters came to me seeking to know more of this boy who had saved them, whom I had laid at their doorstep. I told them many stories. One might even consider them true. Is there anything else? Knowledge of me? Of our wonderful world? You stand before Myrdra, spirit of the natural world, daughter of stem and stream. My sisters and I are the glorious weavers of all wild beauty. When mountain, spring, and sturdy tree trunk take your breath, sweet beast, that is us. That is our blessing. An immeasurable number. Mother Stem and Mother Stream rely on us to sprawl and grow. Though we don't often commune with beasties such as you. Not in this age. Especially not since what happened to Kaola. A tragedy, beast. Tragedy most cruel. Kaola was fascinated by mortals, by your lives and stories. Unlike most of us, she made herself no secret. And you worshipped her with your short lives. Even built her a house. A temple, you called it. The root found her there. We godlings are not easily unwoven, however. And it slew her not. But perhaps it would be better if it had. For what remains is no longer the sister I knew. But we hold happy thoughts. Regret only wastes one life with another. Is there something else we can talk about? By day, a dappled glade of emerald branch and golden leaf, carpeted by downy moss. By night, sweet beast, the trees bewitch the lost and inebriated. Or so it was before this age of extermination. How I long to return to play. This age, for me, holds only decay. Farewell, sweet beast.
Shit. It's over. That's it. For now. Do this. Thank you. Here they come.
Come on.
Did you bring me? Okay.
Oh, traveler. Where to find me.
Yeah, I don't trust this place.
Okay, this is it. Whew, boy.
Okay, this is it.
We must speak again. Friend Paxultek, it returns. Of course, many seasons ago, Paxultek and I spoke of songs and... of course. It is not the same Paxultek. Forgive me. The horn. It does not have them. A new friend, then. So what brings it to beleaguered Yesha? It speaks of the one of many. The once god and guardian of the Pan. There is, or was, no being in Yesha more powerful. Yet now it is corrupted. It rests now within the Thane, befouling its very leaf and limb. Travel through this temple to the far woods and on to the Widow's Court. The Thane can be found thus. But beware, friend Paxultek. The Thane is a dark place, bedeviled by the rot that now consumes our forest. Tread lightly. Yes. Ask its questions, Paxultek. Quite so. Paxultek have graced this world for generations. The Elder, the one it calls Ford. The Destroyer, to whom many faces fell. The Wanderer, who faced the Ravager and lived. Alas. Songs are not song of Paxultek, but I am blessed to have met many. its kind bring this one joy and song. I rest only. These lands have not been safe since the One of Many was taken from us. Yet none have bothered me here as of yet. The forest dies, Baksutek. The balance has either failed or betrayed us. There is little hope now, except in song. Even now, yes. Corruption swallows all things, and the balance is held in check. Or perhaps the balance turns against the Pan. The outcome is the same. It began slowly at first. A remote grove in the forest. Then the death of our god. Now, even the beasts, the gods, and nature itself succumb to the rot. Some blame Baksutek. But though Baksutek have come and gone, the rot both precedes and remains. If fault lies anywhere, I think it may lie with the Pan. Praise be the One of Many. Mortal faces lie, but the One of Many is incapable, veracious beyond question. So goes the song. The God of Many Faces has watched over every generation of the Pan, even before our people found Yesha. Even when our songs praised the tree over the God. Yet our negligence brought the cost. And the One of Many was killed by, forgive me, a most recusant Baksutek. Now the waning of our great tree has allowed corruption to come, infecting our once mighty guardian. I fear greatly for Yesha, friend Baksutek. But we must hold faith in the balance. Ah, the Eternal Empress, Genus the Perennial, Mistress of the Thane, favored of great Genus has so many titles, I can scarce remember them all. It was she who discovered the Tree of Life, and it is she who brings peace to the Pan for generation after generation. The Thane is our life, the Empress our root. Yet the tree wanes, and corruption devours Yesha's every corner. Her divine permanence has protected us for long and long, but is she as enduring as the songs say? Listen to me. I must trust the songs. Hope and faith are kin. The blessing of Yesha, go with you.
Yeah.
That's over.
All right. cover? That's over. Thank you. Here we go. I've got enough of that. Oh, the bag's full.